Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO of Bone Biologics, Jeff Frelick. Jeff, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for having me, Natalie.
My pleasure. Now let's dive right in and introduce you to our investor community. How does the company specialize in regenerative medicine, but particularly focusing on bones and spinal fusions and orthopedics?
Yeah, so we're focused on bone regeneration. Also, skeletal reconstruction is another way to put it. But this is specifically for spine fusion patients, patients that present with degenerative disc disease. We participate in the orthobiologics market. This is a subset of the overall orthopedics market. So we're developing a bone graft substitute. This is an alternative to autograft. This is where patients, their own bone is harvested from them for surgery. This is an alternative to that. And so, a much simpler procedure. And, the product has demonstrated so far much success in the animal models, good quality and quantity of bone, and, demonstrating a very strong safety profile as well.
Right, because there's really only one, maybe two ways to access your bone if you need to have treatment for like bone marrow treatment and whatnot, and very painful. So very interesting to hear more about it and the new update for the pilot clinical trial that is in the works and engaging in a contract research organization. Where's the company at with that?
Yeah, thanks. We recently announced our CRO partner. So the trial will be 30 patients in Australia. We've engaged a CRO down there to help manage this clinical trial process. There will be three arms to the pilot clinical trial, two treatment arms and a control group. They've begun to enroll surgeons and hospitals. So we'll have somewhere between 5 and 10 sites coordinating this. And so we have two set up so far, and this will continue as we move forward to late 3Q is when we anticipate initiating the pilot clinical trial.
Right. And what is the goal for the clinical trial?
Yeah. So we'll look at fusion rates versus the control. So with the nail regenerating bone, healing that patient stronger, faster. There'll be interim data at 6 months and then again 12 months. And the idea is that the surgeon will image that patient at those two time points and look for fusion. Fusion is typically demonstrated by you're seeing a bridging effect between the two vertebrae that are connected. And then also look at pain management scores, an ODI index, and then any type of adverse events. So those will be the three endpoints.
And Jeff, going back to what is already out there for bone treatments, how important is it to have an alternative to something that can be very painful, very long recovery, and giving more options to patients?
Yeah, so the orthobiologics market is one that's quite large. It's about $3 billion market opportunity. There's a lot of players in the market. A lot of them are the product is for osteoconductivity, more providing like a lattice effect for the patient's own bone to grow through that and interdigitate. Osteo inductive, where it can grow bone from scratch. There's a key player on the market there. We're more of an osteopromotive product where we look to regenerate and grow bone, but only in the presence of bone, not in the surrounding tissue. We think that's an attractive to the product, and especially highlighting our strong safety profile. So there's definitely an unmet need in really helping patients form good bone. The challenge that surgeons often speak about is patients that could present as kind of a hard healer. They have these comorbidities where they may be diabetic, obese, smokers, immunocompromised, and they need a lot of help in growing bone. And really what the surgeon's trying to avoid is any type of revision where that patient presents itself again because the fusion didn't take, and it's a burden to the patient, it's a burden to the healthcare system. So they really want to secure good solid fusion when that surgery is complete.
Very interesting stuff. Thank you so much for sharing, and we can't wait to hear more updates about the pilot clinical trial.
Thank you.
Again, the CEO of Bone Biologics, Jeff Frelick.